These sounds are neither some kind of experimental music or even aliens trying to communicate with us. These are actually the noises that an acoustician has to listen to for 4 or more hours when measuring a room. So, if you're an acoustician, hats off to you. So it's finally time to do the last part of this video series regarding the studio build. Of course, there will be a video that will be a studio tour of this place, but I couldn't do that video without completing this series. As you can probably see, if you check the date that I uploaded the last part of this series, I certainly took my sweet time with it, and now it's been almost a year that this place is complete. Anyway, today is all about the acoustic measurements and treatment of both the control and the live room, and I can say that this part was, in my mind and still is, the most important part of this whole build. Because in this step, the sound of the studio is defined depending on how you treat the live room, and also this is the part where you have to build a control room that you can trust when you are mixing. Of course, now that I'm saying that, that's not entirely true, because everything starts from how the rooms are built, but taking for granted the way the rooms were built, their shape, the materials, all that stuff, this was the part that I really wanted to be done right. And I'm happy to say that it most definitely was done right. Of course, there's a lot of work and progress to be done, but the foundation is here and it already sounds much better than I expected. To start things off, I have never really been a fan of dead live rooms, so the concept for the live room was quite simple. I had two goals in mind. I wanted a live room that would be as live as possible while still being able to record a small band live in it. Also, I didn't want to make the room a rehearsal room as well, because then it would have to be much more dead than it is right now. So the idea was quite simple, but the execution had to be correct, and it also had to fit within my remaining budget. Regarding the control room, I really didn't have a specific concept, but what I learned throughout this process with the help of the acoustician that did all the measurements is that the two rooms have to work together, so the way that you treat the one room also defines the way that you treat the other one. So anyway, as I said, I didn't have a specific idea about how I wanted the control room to be, so I decided to trust the acoustician that did all the measurements. This whole process consisted of two big parts, really. The first one was measuring the empty room so that we could determine how much absorption, diffusion, or anything else would be needed. After that, and some budget discussion and consideration, we came up with a plan. Because of the sound that I wanted, especially from the live room, we decided to go with a hybrid approach, which means that we have absorption panels with diffusion in front of them, for the most part. Of course, there were spots where bass trapping would be needed, but the whole concept was that. So, after everything was agreed upon, the build of the panel started. I decided that I wanted to finish the wooden panels myself, so that I could choose the way that they looked, the color and everything else, and also cut down on some of the cost. Plus, I really wanted to build something in this place. Anyway, when everything was ready, it was time for the second measurement, during which the position of each panel would be determined. Of course, we had a rough idea of where everything should go, but especially in the live room, there was some experimentation to be done with the position of the panels and how the room would react to them. Because we decided in the end to go with a more bare bones approach and revisit it and add things if needed in the future. Also, at the same time, we could try to find the sweet spot of the control room with the speakers that I had back then. So after that was done, all that was left was for the panels to be mounted at the positions that we decided they should go. That was a pretty straightforward process, with the exception of the ceiling panels, which had a bit of preparation to be done. But in the end, everything went well, with some help from my friends. So I think that sums up this video series. All in all, it was a quite intense experience with lots of ups and downs. But I'm happy to say that in the end, everything went well and almost according to plan. Now, of course, the last part of this whole series is going to be doing a studio tour of this whole place. And then finally, some music-related stuff, which hopefully will come in the near future. I'm really excited about them as well. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. My name is Talam, and I'll see you in the next one.